In the world of networking and web architecture, there are several terms that often come up. To state specifically, they usually are proxy, reverse proxy, and load balancer. While they might sound similar, they serve different purposes and play crucial roles in ensuring efficient and secure communication between clients and servers. In this video, let's understand each one of them one by one. So, let's get started. Starting with, what is proxy, or also known as proxy server? Well, in simple terms, a proxy is like a middleman or a representative that acts on your behalf. Let's imagine you want to access a website, but instead of connecting directly to the website, you ask someone else to do it for you. That person becomes your proxy. They fetch the information from the website and pass it back to you. In the digital world, a proxy server works similarly. It sits between your device, like a computer or a smartphone, and the website you want to visit. When you send a request to access a website, it goes through the proxy server first. The proxy server then sends the request to the website on your behalf, receives the response, and sends it back to you. Proxies can serve different purposes as well. One common use is to enhance privacy and security. When you use a proxy, the website you visit sees the proxy's IP address instead of your own. This helps to hide your identity and location, making it more difficult for others to track your online activities. Proxies can also be used to bypass certain restrictions or censorship. For example, if a website is blocked in your country, you can use a proxy server located in a different country to access the website. Some of the advantages of using proxy servers include caching, anonymity, and content filtering. Next, let's understand what is a reverse proxy. Now, a reverse proxy is also a server that acts as an intermediary between client devices such as your computer or smartphone and web servers, which is quite similar to how a proxy is positioned. But the difference is that while proxy servers primarily serve the client, reverse proxy servers work on the server side. Confused? Let me help you understand this in a simpler way. When you use a regular proxy, you send your request to the proxy server and it forwards those requests to the internet on your behalf. The proxy server acts as a representative or substitute for you when communicating with websites or services. It can help you bypass restrictions, enhance privacy, and improve performance by caching content. On the other hand, a reverse proxy is positioned between the internet and the servers. It handles the requests coming from clients and routes them to the appropriate server within an organization's network. And that's why, instead of representing the client, a reverse proxy represents the server. When a client sends a request to a proxy server, the proxy server evaluates the request and determines which server should handle it. It then forwards the request to that server and releases the server's response back to the client. This setup helps distribute the workload across multiple servers, improves performance by caching content, and adds an extra layer of security. Furthermore, some of the known advantages of using reverse proxy includes load distribution, enhanced security, SSL termination, caching, and content delivery. And to summarize, a regular proxy is used by clients to indirectly access resources on the internet, while a reverse proxy is used by servers to handle incoming requests from clients. One can say that regular proxies act on behalf of clients, while reverse proxies act on behalf of servers. Never forget that. Next, let's understand what is a load balancer. Now, imagine you have a popular website that receives a lot of visitors. Each time someone wants to access your website, they send a request to your server asking for the web page. Now, let's say your server gets overwhelmed with too many requests because of high traffic. That's why it may slow down or even crash, leaving your visitors frustrated. Now, here's where load balancer comes in. A load balancer is like a traffic cop for your website. It sits between the visitors and your servers, distributing the incoming requests in a balanced way among the multiple servers. Here, the load balancer receives a request from a visitor and decides which server is the least busy or the best fit to handle that request at that time. It then forwards the request to that server which possesses it and sends the response back to the visitor through the load balancer. The load balancer also keeps track of server's workload and can dynamically adjust the distribution of requests based on factors like server capacity, response times, or the type of request. This way, it helps ensure that no single server is overloaded while maximizing performance and minimizing downtime. Further, let's understand the difference between reverse proxy and a load balancer. So, while a load balancer focuses on distributing traffic across multiple servers, a reverse proxy focuses on handling and optimizing individual requests. And in some cases, a reverse proxy may include load balancing capabilities as part of its functionality as well. This means that a reverse proxy can act as a load balancer in some cases. But conversely, not all load balancers can provide the additional features of a reverse proxy. That's why we can say that a load balancer distributes incoming traffic across multiple servers to ensure efficient resource utilization, while a reverse proxy acts as an intermediary between clients and servers, enhancing performance and security while handling individual requests. In conclusion, I'd like to say that while proxy servers, reverse proxy servers, and load balancers all serve as an intermediary between client and server, they have distinct roles and functionalities. Proxy servers focus on client-side functions, providing benefits like caching and content filtering. Reverse proxy servers handle requests on the server side, distributing traffic, enhancing security, and caching static content. And load balancers specialize in evenly distributing incoming requests across multiple servers, ensuring scalability, high availability, and efficient resource utilization. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you like my content, feel free to smash that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.